the bargain for pizza. Such love of labor. It is cold. Florence, Italy, January 2021. And yeah, I got a song stuck in my head again. Where'd the cheese go? I don't know. Today, it is looking better and better in Italy. We have the numbers for coronavirus going down and down. And in fact, Italy is one of the leading nations in vaccinating its population. One of the top nations, in fact, in Europe, and one of the leading nations in the entire world. And that's a good thing because that means the restaurants are now open. People can dine inside. There's something I want to do, something I haven't done in a long time, and that's eat a pizza. Where is the best pizza in the world? Well, many would say where it was conceived, in Italy. And where is the best pizza in Italy? Is it in Naples? Is it in Sicily? Is it in Rome? Well, many say it's the former, in Naples, in Napoli, where they created many of the pizzas that we eat nowadays. But where is the best pizza in Florence? I've asked you, some of my followers on Instagram, on Twitter, to give me your thoughts. Now, some of you yahoos out there, you name Domino's, you name Pizza Hut, you name Papa John's, come on. Some of you gave some good suggestions. Now the best pizzeria is the one that's open. Yesterday I passed by my preferred pizzeria in Florence, Mangia Pizza, and they were closed. I asked the guy next door, and he says they've been closed since October due to COVID reasons. So soon I hope they'll reopen, and I promise I'll make another video about that sometime soon. But today I'm at Pizzeria Da Michele, and this place has been around for 150 years. It started as all good pizzerias should in Naples, and now has 7 locations around the world. Rome, Milan, of course Naples, here in Florence, Tokyo, London, everywhere. This place is here in San Lorenzo between the train station and the Duomo. Usually it's crawling with tourists. Now it's not so much because of COVID. But it's a prime location for a pizzeria because you get all that traffic. You can eat here, have a good pizza, and then roam the streets in a pizza coma and get a gelato. That's what you want. Today, I got the Pizza Margherita. This is Romolo. He's from Napoli. He knows how to make a pizza, and today he's making my pizza, Pizza Margherita. He's putting it in the oven right now. There it is, the pizza hot out of the oven. I thought it was gonna be in there for a few minutes. 50 seconds only it takes to make a pizza Napolitano. We're gonna get into this. Now this Pizza Margherita is basic. It has 3 main ingredients: basil, tomatoes, and fiore di latte cheese. I spoke with Romolo, who made this pizza, and he said that the tomatoes come from Campania, the cheese from near Sorrento, the basil also from Campania. It's a pizza made in the South. Now, the legend is Pizza Margherita was named after Queen Margherita in 1889 when a pizzaiolo, a pizza maker in Naples, made a pizza in her honor. And so it's called the Pizza Margherita, with those 3 colors that represent Italy: red, white, and green, the tricolore. The legend may or may not be true, because that concoction of pizza, those ingredients, it reportedly had been around since 1820, so even before Queen Margherita and what we know now as the Pizza Margherita. Now, if you're wondering the cost of all this goodness, just $6.50 for the Pizza Margherita, Italy's basic pizza. Usually in the South you find, this is so delicious. Usually in the South you find food is a bit cheaper. In the North it's more expensive as you get towards the border with Switzerland and Germany and Austria. And here in the middle of Italy, central Italy, the prices, it's an average of the two. So $6.50, it's a bargain for pizza. Such love of labor. You can taste it in this pizza, from Romolo, the pizza maker, to the owners. This is my first time here at this pizzeria, and I'm loving it. Da Michele. this, some packages arrived. I just got back home, but first things first, I need coffee. Today, got my coffee. Now time to get into some of these packages. Just came in from Amazon. Coconut oil, always useful in the house. Multivitamin, that'll keep me healthy all winter long because it's cold out there. Look at that, a new ball head for my tripod. I need to mount this camera on a new tripod. It's the Canon G7X Mark III. Has a cold shoe mount on here as well. That'll be important for mounting accessories, a microphone, a light, anything you might need. An extra cold shoe is always welcomed. I'll have to figure it out. Ooh, Lancy, I can mount that up to the top of a tripod. Came with a little here, Allen key. I've been waiting for this for a while. Now I weigh my coffee. When I grind it in there, I get about 15 grams for a single shot basket in my espresso machine. But the current scale that I'm using only goes down to a gram. This goes down to a tenth of a gram. So it should allow me to get precise measurements. There are some crazy expensive scales out there for like 200 euro for a scale. I think this one cost about 60 bucks. I'll put links for these items down below in the description. So if you're interested in any of this stuff, check it out down below. That's not what I f***ing ordered. This doesn't look like the Black Mirror I ordered. It looks like something a lot cheaper, so I'm gonna be sending that back. Let's talk pizza, because there are some good videos out there on YouTube. Last night I was watching this great video made by the series Munchies. It's about this pizzaiolo, a pizza maker in Brooklyn, who during the COVID pandemic, when that started in New York City, she started selling pizzas out of her house. Free for people who couldn't afford it, free for frontline workers, and for the rest, you make a donation. The price is up to you, how much you want to pay. It's a great story. I'll put a link to that video down in the description below. And that song I was singing before, Where'd the Cheese Go? That is Ween. You have to check. Pizza Hut never used it, but it was a good song, and they put it out as a B-side, or they put it out on a compilation CD that they came out with at the time. One thing in Italy, they don't serve the pizza sliced as they do in the United States. And another thing is that you use knives and forks. So it doesn't come sliced. You don't share a pizza with your friends. You normally get a pizza that's small portion for one person. You eat it with knives and forks, and maybe you pick it up and eat those final pieces with your hands. It's delicious. Now, why don't I eat pizza very much? Well, it's a bomb. An overload of salt, an abundance of carbs in that dough, and it's just an indulgence. That's why I don't eat pizza that much. But it became so popular after it was invented in the 1800s, and then it grew in the 1900s as something cheap and easy to eat. So especially post-war era, people loved pizza, and Italy became known for its pizza. It's one of those icons, just like I talked about with the Vespa video, which is linked up here above. So check that out if you haven't looked at it already. It may be a bomb of salt, fat, and carbs, but it's fast, inexpensive, and delicious. You can see why it took off from Naples and grew globally to become iconic for Italy. For me, this is one of the best, if not the best, pizzas in Florence. Da Michele. Also check out Mangia Pizza, which is pretty good as well. That's my rundown of pizza in Italy and in Florence. Where do you go when you want the best pizza in your home area? What pizzeria do you frequent? You know how it works with this video. If you like it, share it on social media. As they say, spread it like butter.